I want to talk to you today about how your words become your reality. You are where you are today in part because of what you've been saying about yourself. Words are like seeds. When you speak something out, you give life to what you're saying. If you continue to say it, eventually that can become a reality. Whether you realize it or not, you are prophesying your future. And this is great when we're saying things like, I'm blessed, I'm strong, I will accomplish my dreams, I'm coming out of debt. That's not just being positive, you are prophesying victory, prophesying success, prophesying new levels. Your life will move in the direction of your words. But too many people go around prophesying just the opposite. I never get any good breaks. I'll never get back in shape. Business is slow. I'll probably get laid off. Flu season is here. I always get it. They don't realize they are prophesying defeat. It's just like they're calling in bad breaks, mediocrity, lack. The scripture says we will eat the fruit of our words. You are planting seeds when you talk. At some point, you're going to eat that fruit. My challenge is make sure you're planting the right kind of seeds. If you want apples, you have to sow apple seeds. If you want oranges, you can't plant cactus seeds, poison ivy seeds, mushroom seeds. You're going to reap fruit from the exact seeds that you've been sowing. In other words, you can't talk negative and expect to live a positive life. You can't talk defeat and expect to have victory. You can't talk lack, not enough, can't afford it, never get ahead, and expect to have abundance. If you have a poor mouth, you're going to have a poor life. If you don't like what you're seeing, start sowing some different seeds. Many people don't realize with their words, they're cursing their future. Every time you say, I never get any good breaks, you just cursed your life. I'll never be able to afford that nice house. I'll never break this addiction. I'll never meet the right person. No, stop cursing your future. Sometimes the enemy doesn't have to defeat us. We defeat ourselves. Pay attention to what you're saying. Are you blessing your life or are you cursing it? Proverbs 6 says, we are snared by the words of our mouth. Snared means to be trapped. Your words can trip you. What you say can cause you to stumble. It can keep you from your potential. You're not snared by what you think. Negative thoughts come to us all. When you speak them out, you give them life. That's when they become a reality. When you say, I'll never get back in shape, it becomes more difficult. You just made it harder. When you say, I never get any good breaks, that stops the favor that was ordained for you. If you say, I'm not that talented, I don't have a good personality, that is setting the limits for your life. That is calling in mediocrity. You may have been snared in the past, trapped by your words, but I believe this is a new day. I declare you're coming out of that trap. Every chain is being loosed. Every stronghold is coming down. No weapon formed against you is going to prosper. Now you got to do your part. Start speaking victory over your life. Speak increase. Dare to declare God's favor. Be bold to call in those things you're dreaming about, those things you're believing for. Don't use your words to describe the situation. Use your words to change the situation. See, in life, there are always two voices vying for your attention, the voice of faith and the voice of defeat. You'll hear a voice saying, like I did, problem's too big. It's not gonna work out. Just accept it. You'll be tempted to worry, to be negative, to complain. But if you listen carefully, you'll hear another voice, the voice of faith, saying God has a way. Favor is coming. Healing is coming. Breakthroughs are coming. One voice will tell you, you've reached your limits. You've gone as far as you can. You don't have what it takes. The other voice, you are well able. You can do all things through Christ. Your best days are still in front of you. Now here's the beauty. You get to choose which voice comes to life. The way you do it is by what you speak. When you verbalize that thought, you're giving it the right to come to pass. If you go around saying, the problem's too big, I'll never get well, You are agreeing with the wrong voice. You've got to get in agreement with God. The other voice may seem louder, but you can override it. You can take away all of its power by choosing the voice of faith. Maybe you're going to a job interview. One voice will tell you, you're not going to get it. You're wasting your time. These people are not going to like you. Another voice will say, you have the favor of God. You're blessed, you're confident, you have what it takes. But if you get up that morning, tell your spouse, I don't think I'm gonna get this job. They're not gonna like me, I'm not qualified. There's no use even going. You're being trapped by your words. You have to dig your heels in and say, I am not giving life to any more defeat. I am not speaking lack. I'm not speaking sickness. I'm not speaking mediocrity, not enough. I'm gonna choose the voice of faith. It says I'm strong, I'm healthy, I'm blessed, I'm favored. I am a victor, not a victim. You can talk yourself out of your destiny. Negative words can keep you from becoming who you were created to be. Don't fall into that trap. Quit calling in defeat. Quit talking about how it's not going to happen. You can pray in faith, ask God to turn it around, to do the impossible, but then walk away and start talking about how you're not going to get well, how your child's never going to straighten up. Those negative words just canceled out that prayer. Don't let your words trip you. Negative talk brings negative results, but when you speak faith, favor, victory, that's what allows God to do the impossible. When you face giants in life, when you face challenges, you have to do like David, prophesy your future. Say to that cancer, cancer, you are no match for me. I will defeat you. This addiction may be in my family for years, but this is a new day. The buck stops with me. I'm the difference maker. I am free. The mountain looked big, but he declared it would be flattened out. It would become a molehill. There's the principle. Don't talk about the mountain, talk to the mountain. Look at that mountain of debt, tell it, you can't defeat me. You're coming down, I will lend and not borrow. My cup will run over. Whatever mountains you face in life, no matter how big they look, don't shrink back in fear. Don't be intimidated, rise up in faith. Tell that mountain, you're coming down. Tell that sickness, you're temporary. Say to that loneliness, that addiction, that legal problem, who are you, O great mountain, to stand before me? In other words, don't you know who I am, a child of the Most High God? Haven't you read my birth certificate? My Father created the universe. He breathed life into me, crowned me with His favor, called me more than a conqueror. That means you can't defeat me. You can't hold me back. Mountain, you've got to come down. I will overcome this illness. You should write down your goals. Write down what you want to see happen in life. Any areas that you're struggling in, where you need to improve, write it down like it's already done. And then every day, declare that decree. Read over it a couple of times out loud. It's not enough to just think it. Something happens when we speak. You have to prophesy your future. You can personalize yours. But let me give you some generic things that should be on your decree. I am strong. I am healthy. I am in shape. I weigh what I'm supposed to weigh. I am full of energy. I am passionate. I am talented. I am secure. I am valuable. I am confident. I have a good personality. People like me. I am fun to be around. I am happy. I enjoy my life. I am a person of excellence. I am full of integrity. I am successful. I am prosperous. My future is bright. My children are mighty in the land. My legacy will live on to inspire future generations. I run with purpose in every step. I am blessed. I am victorious. I am a child of the Most High God. If you keep speaking things like that over your life, those words will get down on the inside of you. They'll not only change your outlook, but they will change who you are. Your words will become your reality. You are prophesying your future. Over time, Those words will become a part of your everyday vocabulary. It'll be no big deal for you to go around saying, I'm blessed, I'm healthy, I have the favor of God. Instead of being trapped by your words, you'll be propelled by your words.